Hello everyone. This is the part 2 of my IwaOi series. I just want to apologize for this shitty work, for I have been stuck making this part. I can't figure out how to make the flow of the story anymore. Part 3 is already done. I will just need to edit it. I literally cried making the ending of the series, so I hope you all liked it. That is all, and thank you so much for 1k subs. You guys are the best. I love you so much.
Oikawa is now standing at Iwajimi's front door. His hands are trembling while reaching the doorbell on the side. He didn't know why he was so nervous when he had done nothing wrong. He was afraid and doesn't even know why. He rang the doorbell 2 times but nobody answers. He rang it again 4 times but still nobody comes to open the door. He knew this would happen, but he didn't want to use his spare key to open the door. He sighed and was about to try ringing the doorbell for the last time when Iwajimi opens it. IWHN. Iwajimi stares at him with a blank expression. Oikawa doesn't know what he's thinking, and that scares him more. What are you doing here? I told you not to come, right? Can we have a talk inside? No. Please. Let me explain. No. IWHN, please. I didn't mean to do. Oikawa was stopped mid-sentence when Iwajimi drags his hand and pull him inside the house while shutting the door behind him with a bang. Iwajimi then pinned Oikawa at the door and looked at him coldly. What are you going to explain? Iwajimi moves his head closer to Oikawa to the point that both of their noses are touching each other. Are you going to tell me how did you kiss him? Oikawa was surprised by Iwajimi's action. He was about to say something when Iwajimi kissed him aggressively. Iwajimi forced his tongue inside Oikawa's mouth and continued to kiss him roughly. Oikawa is trying to free himself from Iwajimi's grasp, but he was just too strong. He licked Oikawa's chin up to his ear and nibbled it. Iwajimi whispered to his ear. Tell me, is he better than me? How far did you guys go? Iwajimi runs his hand from Oikawa's bottom to his waist and pull him closer to him. Where did he touch you? Stop it. Please. Iwajimi looks at him when he heard his voice trembling and cursed under his breath. He saw Oikawa's eyes welling up with tears. Just go home, I told you not to come here. He was about to turn around when his eyes falls on Oikawa's neck. Iwajimi touched the red mark on his neck. Oikawa froze in his position. What the fuck is this? Are you kidding me right now? That was an accident. How far did you guys go with that accident of yours? Did you enjoy it? I didn't know I have this. I just realized this morning when I took a shower. I don't want any of this to happen, IWHN. I don't know how to explain myself, but what I can assure you is that I didn't want this. You don't want it, but you let it happen. You let yourself get drunk when you know you can't handle it so well. You let him left a mark on you. What else? What else are you hiding from me? Did you guys have sex? What? No. I would never do that. Where did you sleep that night then? You were drunk, right? Where did you sleep? I woke up in his bed, but we didn't. Stop. Please stop this now and go home. Iwajimi starts to walk away from Oikawa. He was trembling from anger, frustration, and pain. He clenched his fist, restraining himself from finding Kuro and beat the crap out of him. Are you breaking up with me? Iwajimi turns to look at him with a glint of anger in his eyes. What? Why are you bringing that up now? What? Do you want to break up with me? No, I don't want to. Then why are you saying that? Why do you always resort to break up, Oikawa? Why do you always tries to break up with me when we have a problem? You're always the one who gives up first. Why is it so easy for you to leave me? That's not what I meant, baby. Can you just go home? Please leave me alone. I don't want to see you right now. Iwajimi continues to walk away from Oikawa, but he was stopped on his tracks when someone hugged him from behind. Please, let's talk. Let's fix this, okay? What do you want to say? I miss you so much. Is that all? No, please listen to me. I don't want to make any excuses. I know what I did is wrong, whether it's intentional or not. I know. I hurt you. I don't know what to do right now, IWHN. I'm scared. Oikawa noticed Iwajimi's fist clenched so hard that his veins are popping out of his arms. He rub his thumb on Iwajimi's hand and kiss him on the nape. Iwajimi relaxed a little with the gesture. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, I promise that will never happen again. I will never drink anymore when you're not around. So please forgive me, if forgiving is that easy then everyone is committing a mistake already. Baby please, forgive me. I don't know if I can. Not now, I've seen and heard enough. What should I do? I will do everything for you to forgive me. Tell me. It's not easy, Oikawa. Do you even know what I feel right now? I was so mad that I want to beat that guy, and seeing you right here in front of me is so hard. Images of you with him and what might possibly happen on that night keeps on playing in my head. I'm going crazy. I want it to stop. I'm mad, but seeing you right now after 2 fucking weeks makes me want to just forget everything and please, just leave me alone. Baby. You need to go home now. We're both tired, we need to rest. Leave now. No. I don't want to. I won't leave you. Can you stop being stubborn and just leave? I need to be alone. Why? What for? I need to think. Think of what? Oikawa. Please leave me alone. But promise me that you're not breaking up me when I leave now. Okay? Promise me. You won't leave me. Go now while I'm still sane. Why do I feel like when I leave you now, I won't be able to see you tomorrow? Why I do feel like you're drifting away from me? Iwajimi removes Oikawa's hand from his waist and walks away from him. Go home now, Oikawa. We both need space.